Ladies and gentlemen, now appearing from the Atomic 3D Lounge, the one, the only, filthy 3D Joke Man, featuring Jackie the Joke Man Martling. I have insider information from the Joke Man himself that this new animated video is more sophisticated, classy, if you know what I mean. So, without further ado, here he is, the fabulous, filthy 3D Joke Man! How we doing, everybody? All right, hands!
How you doing, lady? You're very pretty for a girl.
That's good.
Gynecologist comes home from work. His wife says, "You tired?" He says, "Shambushed." Lady's walking down the street. Guy's walking the other way. He says, "Lady, there's a tampon hanging out of your mouth." She says, "Fuck, what'd I do with my cigarette?" And a girl marooned on a desert island. Three guys and a girl marooned on a desert island. After 1 week, the girl's so ashamed of what she's doing, she kills herself. After another week, the guys are so ashamed of what they're doing, they bury her. Hey, after another week, they're so ashamed of what they're doing, they dig her up again. So guy goes to the doctor. He's, "Doc, you gotta help me. I get up in the morning, I fuck my wife. Then I carpool to work with the neighbor's wife, and on the way to work, she blows me. Then I get to work, and every time I go into the Xerox room, one of the young girls follows me in, so I fuck her on the Xerox machine. Then at lunchtime, I take my secretary to a motel, and I fuck her in her ass, because that's how she likes it. Then in the afternoon, at the coffee break, I fuck the boss's wife. Then I get home from work before my wife, and there's the housekeeper, she's always up on all fours. I bang her that way, and then at night, I fuck my wife again." The doctor says, "So what's the problem?" He says, "It hurts when I jerk off." Don't get upset now, lady. In a little while, I'm gonna be so dirty, you're gonna wish you had a fucking cock in each ear. Drunk goes to get in the cab. He says to the driver, "Hey, you got room in the front seat for 3 6-packs on the pizza?" The driver says, "Sure." He goes, "Bleh!" I'll tell you, a terrible one. Guy dies. His wife's looking at his body just before the wake starts. She says, "You know, Charlie looks great, but I always wish that he'd be buried in a blue suit, not a black suit." Funeral director says, "No problem, lady. Hey, Eddie, change heads on number 7 and number 11. The kid says, "Daddy, what's a vagina look like?" "As well, son, before sex, a vagina is like a rose with soft pink velvety petals and the aroma of perfume." "So what about after sex? Did you ever see a bulldog eating mayonnaise?" That joke is worth the fucking price of admission. So what's a 70-year-old snatch smell like? Depends. Why did Jeffrey Dahmer have a blender on his front porch? So he could greet you with a handshake. Nelson is the American champion wrestler. Nelson's the American champion. He's going to France to fight the French champion for the world championship. And his coach says, "Listen, Nelson, you're the best. You're great. But the French champion has got the pretzel hold, and it's a deadly hold. If he gets you in the pretzel hold, you can forget it. But if you stay away from him, I think you can win." Nelson says, "All right, coach, I'll stay away. I'll do what I can. Get out there. The match starts. 20 seconds of the match. Bang! The French champion gets Nelson in a pretzel hold. The coach says, Jesus, he throws in a towel, goes back to the locker room. A few minutes later, there's a big cheer from the crowd. Nelson comes bopping into the locker room. He says, I did it! I'm the world champion, coach! The coach says, well, wait a minute, Nelson. I was out there, and 20 seconds into the match, he got you in the pretzel hold. What do you mean you're the champion? He says, well, I'll run it by you, coach. I get out there. I try to stay away from him. But 20 seconds in, I got too close to him. He got me in that damn pretzel hold, and I was wound around. I didn't know what to do. All of a sudden, I saw these two testicles hanging in front of my face. So, I bit him. Coach says, Nelson, I still don't understand. He said, you'd be surprised, coach, what you do when you bite your own balls. Couple's on vacation. They go up to a wishing well. Guy takes a penny and throws it. Nope. He steps back. His wife takes a penny out. She walks up. She trips. Ass over head. Falls to the wishing well and drowns. The guy's, fuck, it works. Guy's on the elevator with a big fat broad. He says, can I smell your snatch? She says, no. He says, then it must be your feet. It's fucking funny. Guy walks in the luncheonette. Sits down at the counter. He says, I want a bowl of chili. Waitress says, I'm sorry, the guy next to you got the last bowl. He looks over, the guy next to him is almost done eating, but the chili bowl is still full. He says, you're going to eat that? He goes, nah, help yourself. Thank you. Takes the chili bowl, starts eating, gets halfway down, and his fork hits a dead mouse. He's like, oh, bleh! Pukes back in the bowl. The other guy says, that's about as far as I got, too. One morning, two bums are walking through the park. First bum says, geez, I gotta take a dump. His friend says, we'll do it right here. All right. He pulls down his pants and he squats down. All of a sudden he hears, he listens again and he hears, he says, the other bum, he says, man, you hear that? Second bum says, what? He says, listen. Second bum says, man, how long has it been since you ate? First bum says, about 3 weeks. Is that your asshole nibbling on the grass? How do you know if a girl's been on a wild date? She tosses her panties and they stick to the ceiling. The CIA has three new agents that he has to test. A 25-year-old, 35-year-old, and a 45-year-old. Takes each of their wives and puts them in a different room. He gives the 25-year-old guy a gun. He says, go in the room and kill your wife. The 25-year-old guy says, I can't do that. I love it too much. Hang on to your hats. He gives a gun to the 35-year-old. He says, go in the room and kill your wife. He goes in 5 minutes later and says, I can't do it either. I love it too much. They give the gun to the 45-year-old. He goes in the door. The door closes, you hear bang, 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 and he's fighting, scuttling. CIA director goes running, the wife is laying there dead. The director says, what happened? The 45-year-old guy says, some asshole put blanks in the gun, I had to choke her to death. You guys that are recently married, wait about 5 years and then think about that one. Mother Teresa dies. She goes to Pearly Gate. St. Peter gives her a halo. She's walking around. She's late and dies. Standing there with a bigger halo. She goes back to St. Peter. She says, my whole life I gave to the diseased and the poor. Lady Di was born rich. Did a few things for charity. She has a bigger halo than me. St. Peter says, that's not a halo. It's a steering wheel. Here's a fucking great one. Guy goes to visit his grandmother, takes his friend with him. While he's talking to his grandmother, his friend starts eating the peanuts off the coffee table, eats all the peanuts. As they're leaving, his friend says to his grandmother, thanks for the peanuts. She said, yeah, since I lost my dentures, I can only suck the chocolate off them. Old guy goes to the doctor. Doctor examines him. He says, well, my friend, you got cancer and Alzheimer's. He says, well, thank God I haven't got cancer. How fucking funny is that? So why do men pay more than women for car insurance? Because women don't get blowjobs while they're driving. Oh, I hope I don't come to a curve. A curve. Oh, I hope it's a fucking field. Why can't Avon ladies walk fast? They're lipstick. Girl goes to the gynecologist. First time at the gynecologist. She's up in the stirrups. She's scared to death. He says, "You're nervous, aren't you?" She says, "This is my first time at the gynecologist." He says, "You want me to numb you down there?" She says, "Please." He goes, "Num, num, 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 num." Lots of time on the clit, you know what I'm saying, lady? He's got his finger in her ass. He's having a party. She's screaming, "More, less, no, take it out, leave it in. I don't, oh, what's going, oh, oh." He got to work the next day. She was sitting on the stoop waiting for him.
Thanks, Joke Man. So much for classy. You're not gonna hold this against me, are you?
No black jokes tonight. All right. No, it's all right. I checked. Rufus calls up Tepus. That's almost enough for the joke. Rufus calls up Tepus. He says, "Hello, Tepus. Why don't you come on over and watch the football game?" He says, "I can't. I'd lay in linoleum." He says, "Oh, she got a friend?" What's the difference between a white fairy tale and a black fairy tale? A white fairy tale starts out once upon a time. A black fairy tale starts out, "You ain't gonna believe this shit, motherfucker." Cab driver picks up a nun. She gets in the back seat. He looks in the rearview mirror. He says, "You know, sister, I always fantasize about being with a nun." She says, "Yeah, you and everybody else. You Catholic?" He says, "Yes, I am." She says, "Pull over." He pulls over. She gets in the front seat, gives him the best blowjob he's ever had. She gets done. He feels a little guilty. He says, "Sister, I got to tell you something. I'm not really Catholic." She says, "Yeah, well, my name's Ralph. I'm going to a costume party." I'm sorry, any Catholic girls here tonight? Get on your knees, I'll be right over. We'll say grace, then you can eat me. What's the difference between a girl and a toilet? The toilet doesn't want to cuddle after you drop a load in it. You know why you should never drink diet soda during oral sex? Because then you have two aftertastes you have to get rid of. Oh, like you've never done that. Jewish girl runs up to her father. She says, "Daddy, Daddy, I need $50. He says, "$40? What do you need $30 for?" How do you make a Jewish girl scream twice? You fuck her in the ass and wipe your dick on the drapes. So why do Jews watch porno movies backwards? They like the part where the hooker gives the money back. Ah, shit, now the Jews are angry. The Jews are angry, the Italians try and act angry, the blacks are angry, Irish people are throwing up on each other, the Mexicans can't afford to get in, the Chinese people are doing their homework, the Polish people are facing the wrong way, and if the midgets would give me a standing ovation, I wouldn't even fucking know it! So there's a Jewish kid, an Oriental kid, and a black kid in the third grade class. Who's got the biggest dick? The black kid. Why? He's 16. Stokowski goes to see the doctor. He says, "Doc, you gotta give me your strongest aphrodisiac. I got a couple nymphomaniacs coming over tonight, and I wanna really be able to give my shot, you know? Give me a really strong aphrodisiac." So the doctor gives him one, he takes it. Next day, he comes in the doctor's office. His hair's messed up. He's a mess. He says, "Doc, I need some liniment." The doctor says, "Oh, for your pecker?" He says, "No, for my arm. They didn't show." Come on. Doc goes in a pet store. store. He says, my dog ran away. I need another dog. Pet store owner says, you don't want a dog. It's the year 2000. They're big. They're a pain in the neck. You know what you want? This toothless hamster. He says, why would I want a toothless hamster? He says, pull down your zipper and I'll show you. So the guy pulls down his zipper because it helps the joke. Pet store owner takes the toothless hamster, puts it down by the guy's crotch. The hamster lunges out and gives the guy the best blowjob he's ever had. Guy buys the hamster. Goes home, walks in the kitchen, sets the hamster free on the floor. His wife goes, wah! She jumps up in the chair. She says, what's that thing? He says, never mind what it is. Teach it how to cook and get the fuck out. Here we're at a car dealer. There's a black guy staring at a Cadillac. Salesman comes up and says, excuse me, sir, you thinking about buying a Cadillac? He's no. I am buying a Cadillac. I'm thinking about pussy. How do you know when the Orientals have moved into your neighborhood? The Mexicans get car insurance. Think about it, it's very deep. I don't see no fucking sign. Can't see over dashboard. I see fucking sign. I love to goof on the Orientals, but they're actually the best comedy crowd because you can't do bad. No matter what you say, they sit like this. You know how their eyes got like that? From the flash. Ooh. How are we gonna drive? They can hardly see out of those little slits. That's why they're all scared of those phony monsters. Oh, Rodan, I don't see no fucking string. You know what those little bumps are on a woman's nipple? That's Braille for lick here. Oh, the horny blind bastards. Two guys are in a foxhole in Vietnam. One guy says, I can't take it anymore. I'm so horny. Ah! He jumped out of the foxhole. Comes back a half hour later like, oh, yeah. Oh, but he said, you got a little bit? He says, hell yeah, gook broad. I fucked her in the ass. I came on her tits. So why don't you get a blowjob? I couldn't find her head. Washington and Jefferson are out in the country for the very first time. Washington picks up a bug and says, yo, bro, check it out. What kind of bug is this? Jefferson looks at it and says, it's a ladybug. Washington says, damn, you got some good eyes. How can you tell the Polish girl in the nude beach? She's the one with the tampon string hanging out of her asshole. Polish guy stops at a motel. There's a sign over the toilet that says, don't put anything but paper in this bowl. So he shit on the floor. You know why they made white chocolate? So little black kids could get messy too. If you put your hand in a jar of jelly beans, the black ones steal your watch. The old guy goes to the doctor for examination. The doctor tells him he needs a stool sample and a urine specimen. So the old guy gives him his underwear. It's a black guy, a Jewish guy, and a redneck all working construction. It's believable so far. It's a black guy, a Jewish guy, and a redneck working construction, digging a ditch. Also, the black guy's shovel hits something. He picks it up. It's a lamp. He goes to wipe the dirt off, and a genie comes out. Ah! I'll give you each one wish. Says the black guy, what's your wish? I want my own country. So the brothers and sisters can live together in peace and harmony once and for all. The genie says, you got it. He says, Jewish guy, what do you want? He says, I want my own country so my people can live without persecution once and for all. He says, you got it. He says, the redneck, what's your wish? He says, let me get this straight. The black people are all going to live in their own country, and the Jews are all going to live in their own country. The genie says, that's right. He says, fuck it, I'll take a Diet Coke. What's the difference between St. Patrick's Day and Martin Luther King Day? On St. Patrick's Day, everybody wishes they were Irish. Go ahead, pretend that's not fucking funny. Go ahead. 6 o'clock Sunday morning, middle of Harlem. two people approach each other on the street. This is all you hear. Morning, motherfucker. Morning, Reverend. Couple's married 18 years. They're in the same bedroom, but they're in separate beds. And one night, the guy is horny. Oh. He's horny. He says, honey, why don't you come over to Daddy Poo and Daddy make a little whoopee whoopee with Mommy. Come on. Come with Daddy. Daddy love Mommy. Look at him. Make a whoopee whoopee. Make love to Mommy. Come on. She says, all right. Gets out of bed. On the way to his bed, she trips over the rug in the middle. He says, oh, honey, did you hurt your tootsie wootsie? Come to Daddy. Kiss. Give me your toesie. Oh, Daddy make it better. Your toesie better now. Daddy love Mommy. Then he fucks her hard. He gets done. She gets out of his bed. She's on her way back to her bed. She trips over the rug again. He says, you clumsy bitch. Rosenberg is standing at a urinal. Rosenberg's standing there at the urinal. All of a sudden, a big black guy comes running in, whips down a zipper, takes out this huge python, smacks it on the porcelain. Out comes a gusher like a racehorse. He turns to Rosenberg. He says, I just made it. He says, could you make me one in white? France, a guy from California, a guy from New York City, all get caught by cannibals. The cannibals say to the guy from France, ah, we're going to boil you and eat you. He says, oh, sacre bleu, this is ter... He says, sacre bleu, this is terrible. You cannot boil me and eat me. No, sacre bleu, you cannot do this. They say to the guy from California, and you, we're going to chop you up and use your bones to make weapons. He says, oh, wow, dude, don't do that. It's bogus. Don't do it. Don't do it. They say, New Yorker, and you, we're going to peel off all your skin and use your skin to make a canoe. The New Yorker reaches over and grabs a fork from one of the cannibals, starts stabbing himself. He says, yeah, here's your fucking canoe, you cocksucker. Your mother should ride in this fucking canoe. You piece of shit scumbag bastard.
How much lower can we go? Have we hit rock bottom? I don't think so.
Hear about the Polish girl that wanted to give blood and spent 3 hours wringing out her tampons. Three little Polish boys all flunk sex ed. First one says, we gotta get even with that teacher. Second one says, yeah, we'll strip her and tie her up. Third one says, yeah, then we'll suck her cock. Are we having fun or not? Thanks a lot. I didn't really earn that yet, but I had to fart. I needed the cover. Mr. O'Reilly walks into the confessional. He says, oh, Father, it was just last week on the Sabbath. Oh, the old lady and I hadn't had any in so long. And there she was, bending over a sack of potatoes. And her dress was up a bit. And I don't know what got into me, Father, but I gave her a shot right then and there. Will we be thrown out of the church? The priest says, well, no, I don't think you'll be thrown out of the church. He says, that's good, Father, because we were thrown out of the A&P. Dirty Johnny walks into a brothel. He says, hey, lady, I want to catch VD. The madam says, son, why would you want to catch VD? He says, well, I figure if I get it, I'll give it to the babysitter. The babysitter will give it to my old man. My old man will give it to the lady next door, and she'll give it to her husband. He's the son of a bitch that ran over my bike. Store. And there's a perch in front, and there's a parrot on the perch. I fucking love you. And the lady goes walking by, and the parrot says, hey, lady! She says, what? He says, you're really fucking ugly! A few hours later, she goes walking back down the sidewalk. Parrot says, hey, lady! She says, what? He says, you're really fucking ugly. She goes in and says to the pet store owner, that parrot upset me. I'm so upset. I'm going to sue you. I'm going to own this pet store. He says, lady, calm down. I'll talk to the parrot. And it'll never happen again. Next day is pet store to perch parrot. Lady comes walking along. And the parrot says, hey, lady. She says, what? He says, you know. Baby Paul! bear goes up to his mother and says, Mom, am I a polar bear? She says, of course you're a polar bear. He says, no, I mean 100% pure polar bear. She says, yeah, go ask your old man. Goes up to his father and says, Pop, am I pure, 100% pure polar bear? His father says, of course you're 100% pure polar bear. I'm polar bear. Your mother's polar bear. My parents, both polar bear. Her parents, both polar bear. My grandparents, both sides polar bear. Your mother's grandparents, both sides polar bear. Yes, you're absolutely 100% pure polar bear. Why do you ask? He says, because I'm fucking freezing. See, now that's a cute joke. I told that joke to my grandmother. Of course, I left out the fucking, you know. And she said, ah, that's a good one. Of course, the way I heard it, he said, I'm fucking freezing. Two statues in the park. A male statue, female statue, stark naked. For thousands of years, they've been staring at each other. One day, God comes down and touches them on the head and makes them alive for an hour. And the guy says, whoa, you want to do what I want to do? She says, you bet. They run into the woods. 20 minutes later, they come running out sweating and panting. He says, let's rest up a while. And then go do it again. She says, all right, but this time, you hold the pigeons and I'll shit on them. A nun's walking down the sidewalk. He punches her in the stomach. Before she can say anything, he smacks her on the head. She goes down. He kicks her. He picks her up and he smashes her up against the wall. He says, you're not too fucking tough tonight, are you, Batman? Big fat Polish lady pushes a car in a gas station. She says, conked out. The mechanic lifts up the hood, works on the engine a second, starts to purr like a kitten. She says, what's the story? He says, crap in the carburetor. She says, how often I gotta do that?
How do you ditch a Jewish cop? Drive through a toll booth. What would you call a lesbian with fat fingers? Well hung. What do lesbians make for dinner? They don't cook, they eat out.
Guy's hunting. He's in the woods. Sees a bear. Pow! Shoots a bear. Bear falls. He runs up. No bear. It's a tap on his shoulder. He turns around. Bear says,
you just shoot at me?
He says, yeah.
Bear says, suck my cock.
What can you do? It's a bear. He sucks his cock. Swallows. That has nothing to do with the joke, but I like to promote that wherever I can. Guy goes back to the gun store. He says, I need a double barrel shotgun. Guy goes back in the woods. It's a bear. Ba-dum, ba-dum. Bear falls. Runs up. No bear. Tap on his shoulder. It's a bear.
Bear says, you just shot at me twice with a double barrel shotgun, didn't you? He says, yeah. The bear says, pull down your pants and bend over that log.
It's a bear. Bends over the log, and the bear fucks him in the ear. And it takes him a long time to come because the bear just had sex the day before. Guy goes back to the gun store. He says, I need an elephant gun. Guy says, an elephant gun. He goes back in the woods, and there's the bear. Bottle, 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 bottle. The bear falls. The guy runs up. There's no bear. Tap on his shoulder. The bear says,
you don't come here to hunt, do you?
Why do drunks throw up in the gutter? So the homeless can have breakfast in bed. Relax, I used to date a homeless. It was great. End of the night, I could drop her off anywhere. Why is money green? The Jews pick it before it's ripe. Jewish guy in New York City hails a cab. Cab's going down the street. They're looking on the sidewalk. They see a guy hit a lady over the head. She goes down. The guy starts kicking her. The cabbie zooms to the side of the road, jumps out of the cab to go help the woman. The Jewish guy rolls down the window and says, stop it! Stop it! Stop the meter!
How about the rabbi who couldn't eat his wife because she was a pig?
Guy meets a girl in a bar. They go back to her apartment.
Fluffy, Fluffy, Fluffy toy, Fluffy toy. He fucks her. They get done. He says, how was I? She says, take anything from the bottom shelf. You about the new super sensitive condoms? Yeah, after you fuck her, they stay and talk to her. Sullivan's got an incredible stutter, a terrible stutter. He goes to the doctor, he says, Doc, I got this terrible stutter, and I can't meet girls. It's so bad. There's nothing I could try and fix me. Doc says, sure, Mr. Sullivan, take off all your clothes. I'll see what I can do. Sullivan undresses. The doc says, well, look, there's the problem. Look at your male organ. It's huge. My God, that's the largest one I've ever seen. That's the problem. We'll just cut that off and you'll be fine. He said, take it. You can't. No, not that. Pee, my dick. You can't. Mr. Sullivan, I'm sure that's the problem and it's the only solution. He said, but, okay, fine. He said, I can't take the embarrassment. Go ahead. The doctor performs the operation. Well, Sullivan starts going out to bars, and he's meeting babes, rapping to them, taking them back to his place. But then he can't do anything because he's only got a stub to work with. You understand. After about a week, Sullivan's losing. He can't stay. He goes back to the doctor's house. Doctor answers the door. He says, Doc, you did great by me. I talk fine. I meet babes, but I bring them home. I can't do nothing. You got to put it back on. The doctor says, fuck you. Lady says, Doc, kiss me. He says, I can't. She says, come on, Doc, kiss me. He's lady, I can't. She's Doc, please kiss me. She says, look, lady, I probably shouldn't even be fucking you. Doctors. I always wanted to be a gynecologist. I swear to God, if I was a gynecologist, I would have my secretary beep me every 15 minutes to remind me to sniff my fingers. Oh, yeah, I'd put on those little rubber gloves at the end of the day to seal in the flavor. Fuck you guys. Like, you never drove home from a date in high school going, that's fantastic. Man. Wowee. Take a shower, you got one hand outside the curtain. I ain't getting rid of this motherfucker. 2 days later, you're sitting in history class. I can't believe it's still there. That's why a lot of guys have mustaches. It's a flavor saver. So Saturdays in college, I'd see guys with chunks in there, man. I was just... So one morning, a lady says to her husband, Eddie, you want some breakfast? He says, nah, it's the Viagra. He says, I have no appetite. A few hours later, she says, want some lunch? He says, no, the Viagra. I got no appetite at all. Dinner time, she says, want me to get a pizza, some hamburgers? He says, no, the Viagra has completely destroyed my appetite. She says, well, will you mind getting the fuck off me? I'm starving. The first Viagra baby was born, 6 pounds, 12 inches. Stupid jokes, but it is a great drug. Small dose, works in small doses. I use just enough to look good on the beach, and my grandfather used just enough so he doesn't piss on his shoes. Guy takes a girl parking, first time parking. She says, my mother told me to say no to everything. He says, would you mind sucking on my cock? That's the end of that one. Guy gets in bed with his wife. He says, hey, what do you say tonight? Yeah. Yeah. She's not tonight. I'm going to the gynecologist tomorrow and I want to be fresh. He says, you're not going to the dentist, are you? You know, it's so funny. When you've been together a really long time, you tend to not be quite as attentive to one another as you are in the beginning. You know what I'm talking about, especially you guys. Like, it's like living next to a highway. You learn to eventually mentally mute out the drone of the traffic. Then it's like high school. Like, holy shit, if there's a pop quiz, I'll never get another fucking blowjob as long as... It's so funny, though, because even though you're not as attentive, you tend to get on the same wavelength. And this is a true story. About 5 years ago, 8 years ago, me and Nancy are lying in bed, I don't know, drinking a beer, smoking a joint, shooting up, whatever. I'm kidding, we don't smoke in bed, but we were lying there. And I said, what was that? She said, I didn't say anything. I said, you sure you didn't say anything? She said, I didn't say anything out loud. I was thinking something. I said, whoa, I heard you. I heard you thinking. She said, really? What was I thinking? I said, I don't know. I wasn't listening. I know what I was thinking. I was thinking I wish your clit was where your nipples are, but I don't. Couples, the guy always says, yo, Mac, did you know your wife fell out two blocks back? The guy says, thank God, I thought I went deaf. Why don't cannibals eat divorced women? They're too bitter.
Jennifer has very, very tiny boobies. But she hears about a doctor that can help her. She goes to see the doctor. He says, Jennifer, it's very simple. Just wake up in the morning and do a simple exercise. Just touch your breasts and go, Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was white as snow. And if I touch these two like this, they are sure to grow. That's all you got to do. She says, fine. Well, the next day, she goes to her regular regime in the morning and completely forgets. She's, oh, man, she's on the bus. It's not that crowded. She figures, what the hell? Back in the bus, she goes, Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was white as snow. And if I touch these two like this, surely they will grow. All of a sudden, somebody taps her on the shoulder. She's, what? And the guy says, excuse me, do you go to Dr. Schimmel? She says, yeah, how'd you know? He says, hickory dickory dock. Come on!
Everybody's fair game with the joke, man. I just hope my mom is watching.
Every night a girl walks in her house, her mother says, you're 30 years old, you're not married yet. 30 years old, you're not married. She says, Mom, leave me alone. Every night she walks in, her mother says, you know, you're not even engaged. You're 30 years old, no boyfriend, not engaged. You've never been married. 30 years old, never married. Mom, leave me alone. Every night she walks in, you're 30, never been married, not even engaged, never married. Mom, leave me alone. One night she walks in, she got rice in her hair. Her mother says, you did it. You got married. She says, no, I was blowing a chinky, threw up on my head.
The difference between a rabbi and a priest. A rabbi cuts it off and a priest sucks it off. Yeah, go ahead and moan. That's the first true thing I've said all fucking night right there.
Guy's buying a country house down south. The day he's moving in, there's a knock on the door. He answers. The guy says, howdy, neighbor. Why don't you come on over Saturday night? Lots of eating and drinking and fighting and fucking. He says, sounds good, I'll come. What should I wear? He says, don't much matter. It's just going to be me and you.
Why did the rooster cross the basketball court? He heard that the referee was blowing fouls.
Did you hear about the gay whale? He bit the end off a submarine and sucked out all the semen. Guy goes to the bar. He says, could I... have a beer? Bart says, man, you got a stutter. He says, well, no. Right. He says, listen, you know, I used to have a terrible stutter myself. You know what I did? One night I went home and had my wife suck me off 5 times in a row. Bang, 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 bang. I haven't stuttered since. You try it. He says, okay. Comes back the next week, walks to the bar, he says, Bart, can I have a beer? Bart says, man, why didn't you try what I told you? He says, I tried it, it didn't help. But I must say, you got a nice apartment. How do you get a woman to make a noise like a dolphin? You flip her over and try and fuck her in the ass. She goes, $50 billion in research, they found out that dolphins were saying, don't fuck me in my ass! Don't fuck me! Don't fuck me in my ass! He said, all right, class, today we're going to play a little game. I'll ask you some simple questions in American history, and if you get the correct answer, you get a jelly bean. All right. Who
Who discovered America?
Nobody raised their hand. Except a little Japanese kid in the second row. She said, all right, Jimmy Sakamoto. He said, oh! America discovered a fort, a night until Chris McCrumbus, a Spain, Queen Isabella. I think he may be banging her because the three boats, a Nina Pina, Tom Maria, come a rock, a roll, an end ocean rule, come to cross all the way to give the money, buy the ship, but maybe he bang, I don't know, come all the way across there looking for Maca. He finds San Salvador, not America, but close enough to go. Christopher Columbus fought the guy who discovered America, Christopher Columbus, 1492, bong.
Very good, Jimmy. Here's your jelly bean. Okay, who was the father of his country?
Nobody raised a hand except little Japanese kid in the second row.
All right, Jimmy Sakamoto.
Father of his country, George Washington. George Washington, father, president of the United States, erected a 1776 to get a white hair, get a powder in the hair, make a white hair, to bang a mark of Washington. He never done no lie, jumping down, Jerry Keith, done no lie. You look at the dollar bill, George Victor, right, the Mount Rushmore. He's everywhere, George Washington, father of country, 1776, the first president, boom.
Very good, Jimmy, here's your jelly bean.
You know, this clear should be ashamed of itself. Two simple questions in American history and nobody knew the answers except for Jimmy Sakamoto, and he's Japanese. Dirty Johnny stands up and says, fuck the Japs. She says, who said that? He says, Douglas MacArthur in 1945. Throw me a fucking jelly bean. His son jerking off. He says, son, don't do that. You'll go blind. He says, pop, I'm over here.
That's one thing I finally learned to stop doing. I do not jerk off. I mean, the other night I was cleaning it and it went off, but...
You know when Pinocchio realized he was made of wood? The day his hand caught fire.
Yeah, they just came out with a new morning after pill for men. Yeah, it changes your blood type.
A guy from India comes to the United States, gets very ill. He goes to doctor after doctor after doctor. Nobody can help him. Finally goes to an Indian doctor. The Indian doctor says, yes, my friend, take this bucket. Go into the room. Take a shit in the bucket. Piss on the shit that you have just done. Put your nose over the bucket. Inhale the fumes. 10 minutes.
It's his last ditch effort. What's he going to do? He goes in, he shits in the bucket, pisses on the shit, and breathes in 10 minutes. Feels terrific. He comes out, he says, Doc, what was it? He says, you were homesick.
Is in a bus station restroom and he's got to take a dump. Now, I don't mean he has rumblings in his stomach and he's thinking that perhaps he'll eventually have to have a movement. I mean, he got to go. I mean, he got to pinch a loaf. He's at the point where it's not a question of when, it's a question of where. I mean, the turtle's poking his head out. He's at the point where he wouldn't blow his nose on the seat of his underwear at gunpoint, okay? I mean, the corn is ready to ride the rocket.
And he looks, there's only one stall. The stall has no door, and it's just a bowl, not even a ringer on top. But he gotta go so bad. Oh, he goes in, he sits down. Oh. Also, he looks, there's no paper. Now, who would expect a bus station restroom with only one stall with no door with the bowl without even the ring to have no paper?
But it's too late because he's already laying cable. He can't suck it back in. It's a bowl winder. The guy's looking down at a chocolate Carvel, you know.
He knew he's gonna, all of a sudden he looks at his little hole drilled on the side of the stall. And above it, it says, insert and finger will be cleaned by human lips. He's like, thank God he gets done. He wipes with his finger. He sticks his finger in the holes. The guy on the other side with a hammer goes, pow. He goes, ah,
takes off her blouse and her bra, starts sucking on one of her tits. Milk starts coming out. He says, yo, are you pregnant? She says, that's not a nipple, that's a boil.
What's an 850-pound gerbil do for kicks? He shoves homos up his ass. Now you can tell if a guy's gay when you fuck him in the ass, reach around. If he's got a hard-on, faggot!
Stop the stork. The doctor says, shoot it in the air. Shoot it in the air, baby!
Gay guy dies. There's three guys at his funeral. First guy says, after he's cremated, I'd like to toss his ashes from a boat because he so loved it when we went sailing. Second guy says, after he's cremated, I'd like to spread his ashes on my garden because he so loved it when I brought him flowers. Third one says, after he's cremated, I'd like to sprinkle his ashes on some hot chilies so he could tear my asshole apart one last time.
How many pianos did Liberace have? Nobody knows. We know he had organs up the ass. No, Liberace wasn't gay. Here's a quick impression. It's Liberace's mother calling him as a child. You lunchtime faggot!
I'm going to do a few more marriage jokes here, so you fags might want to go take a shit.
What would you call a woman who always knows where her husband is?
A widow.
So a lady's husband's lost all interest in their lovemaking. So she goes to the sex store and buys some crotchless panties. Goes home, takes off all her clothes, puts on just the crotchless panties, lies in bed, waits for him. He comes walking in. She says, I'm up here! So he walks in the bedroom. She's lying there. She says, you see anything you want? He says, why would I want any of that? Look what it did to your panties! What's the smartest thing that ever came out of a woman's mouth? Einstein's cock. E equals MC blow me, lady.
Guy goes, the doc says, doc, I don't know what's the problem with me. Maybe it's, I got a sex problem here. I can't get it up for my wife. Doc says, bring your wife tomorrow. Guy brings his wife the next day. She's undressed, man. She undresses. He lies her down on the table, and doctor walks around the table having a look at her. He pulls the guy aside. He says, you're fine. She doesn't give me a hard-on either.
Guy says to his wife, honey, I think you should start to go braless. She says, really? Do you think my breasts are still perky enough? She says, no, but it might pull the wrinkles out of your fucking face. So a guy goes to a drugstore. He says, I need some condoms for my 11-year-old daughter. Druggist says, your daughter's sexually active at 11? He says, nah, she just lies there like a mother.
Now, I got jokes that I never told. I don't know about. You want to hear all of them? He snored that one of the nuns was on the rag. He tasted blood on the altar boy's cock. See, that's funny, because I thought I just asked you motherfuckers if you wanted to hear. I think maybe we'll skip the next one then. Of course I'm not skipping it. There's two jokes. I just fucking memorized what they are. Relax. So did you hear that now JonBenet Ramsey's father is under suspicion again? Yeah, they think he might have disturbed the crime scene when he jerked off on her body. All right, I just want to see where your fucking line is, folks. That's... Girl says, Daddy, I need a new dress for the prom. He says, you're gonna have to suck my cock. She starts sucking his cock. She says, Daddy, your dick tastes like shit. He says, your brother needed to rent a tuxedo. So Don't you hear Michael Jackson is sharing custody with his ex-wife? Yeah, Michael gets the kids from the waist down. All right, I went a little too far. So three priests are in a boat with three young boys, and the boat starts to sink. The first priest says, "We got to save the boys." Second priest says, "Fuck the boys." The third priest says, "Do you think we got time?" A young guy is sitting in the bar drinking. A young guy is sitting in the bar drinking. Old guy walks up to him and says, "I fuck your mother." Guy keeps drinking. A few minutes later, the old guy comes up and says, "Your mother sucks on my prick." Young guy keeps drinking. The bartender can't believe it, doesn't get a rise out of the guy. A few minutes later, the old guy comes up and says, "I fuck your mother in her asshole." He says, "Pop, you're drunk. Go home."